Hi guys, hope you like the camera angle. If you could see the camera at the moment, it looks as though it's pissed. On the way to a wedding function in Aberaeron, and it's now about 20 past one in the afternoon. Why am I going this early, you may ask? How much are bananas in China? And if a fly travels 5 miles for 3 seconds over a period of 14 days with chocolate on its back, will it reach Outer Mongolia? Those are the Why am I going to this particular venue at this time? Well, they've asked me. There you go, there's your answer. Well, you did ask. Well, I suppose. I'm just trying to think what you'd be asking. Well, no, the deal is that they want me to be set up by 3 o'clock so I can have some background music on. And it's quite cool because I sort of know them as well. So they've said I can join in and sit there and have some grub with them. Taking the SVM, bit of video mixing, got DJ Snips doing a set as well, so it's all going to be funky, and they're a nice crowd, they're up for it. But of course, even if you think they're up for it, they want all the latest dance tunes or whatever, that's not the case, because 9 times out of 10, where weddings are concerned, they will want wedding music. Now that is very important. Do not think for 1 second that you can go to a wedding function and expect to play the music you want. Forget that, because you have to play the music they want, period. And like I said, 9 times out of 10, well, I would say maybe once in every 100 wedding gigs, you will, all right, in that one particular gig, you probably get away with playing loads and loads of dance and whatnot. All right, there's probably a few of you now saying, oh yeah, but I've done 50 this year and I could play anything I wanted. Yeah, all right, well, you're lucky, aren't you? Generally, you have to play stuff, all kinds of things like cheesy 60s, 70s, 80s, whatever. But that is what a wedding is all about. Anyway, I'll stop for a second. I've got a car coming towards me. And it passed, marvellous. Right, so we'll set up and we'll see what happens. Bear with me, said the bishop to the actress. Okay, here we are, Feathers Hotel. I've set up and I'm in here. Been coming here for absolutely years. Used to have really good nights here called World Dance that were just like crazy. Right, not able to set up much else yet because I've got to put the screen over there. Now, years ago, that came out, pulled out, and you could set up on there and you could have stuff behind there, but it's just politics. Won't go into it at the moment now, but you know, everyone has their own means and ways of setting up gear, so I was told to set up there, and with a bit of gentle persuasion, I was able to set up now as opposed to later. And later would have been about 7 o'clock, and the last thing I want to do is start running around everywhere. Anyway, the clients wanted background music during the course of the day, so what they want is what they get. End of story. We'll be right back. fucking horrendous. Crazy night, very good. Up for it, crowd. Yeah, weddings. You know what? You never know what to expect. I knew Snips was going to turn up, do a few tunes, but I didn't know. I knew Joe Knight was going to turn up. I didn't know who was going to play a set, but it worked. It's a crazy night. You know, normally weddings. Sorry. You associate with just cheesy stuff. Well, they were pounding it, and it was good fun. It was bloody good fun. So much respect to the bride and groom, and also Snips and Joe Knight for coming along and spinning a few tunes. But again, if anyone who watches these particular videos, gig logs, mine, anyone else's, and thinks, you know what, DJ Mobile, piece of piss, you're wrong. It's a hard job. It's beyond hard, because there's so much to take into consideration. You know, you've got to have a relatively good music knowledge. You've got to be a bloody good person at communicating. Not just like, oh, look at the crowd, they want something else. But you've got to be able to talk to people. Communication, because you have got to be able to talk to someone who is completely stone cold sober, and then a second later, you have to then talk to someone who is completely stoned or pissed or anything. You know, you don't know. So you've got to do all of this. And then when people turn up and they say, oh, how much do you earn? Oh, I earn this much. God, like, you've only been here 3 hours. Like, well, there's a lot more to it than that, mate. But anyway, we're in this industry because we enjoy it. And also, we're in this industry because we enjoy making people enjoy. I hope you get that, which is of course where we boil down to this one thing. It's practice, and when you make mistakes, just enjoy them. Practice and enjoy them.